it's exciting that we're so early in the development of AI having these conversations, and we're really paying attention.
Right now, several states are proposing legislation on the use of tools in AI and hiring. And so, Amy, I wanted to first start with you and just ask, where do you see the policy environment headed? What can we start to prepare ourselves for?
FPF has an AI legislation tracker that we have been contributing to throughout the course of 2023. And we've seen in the broad AI space alone, at least 20 laws get introduced at the state level. And that is not counting the more specific proposals, like proposals around deepfakes, where that number would go way up. We're expecting this to continue. It's going to be a priority regulatory topic for years to come, both from the perspective of that comprehensive all of AI, from the data protection and privacy laws that have a huge impact on how AI can be developed and what data can be used, as well as more sector-specific proposals.
Elena, I'll punt this question over to you next. You know, as the environment changes, which we know it will because technology is changing every day, how will these guidelines stand the test of time to make sure that we are providing the best guidelines and approach to Gen AI?
One of the things I think that will help the FPF best practices stand the test of time is that they are really based on these fundamental issues that that we see kind of trailing through different proposals, different legislative proposals, but they're also based on that sort of ethical core of being fair to the individuals. And I'll give you an example. We were talking a little bit before about transparency, and transparency is one of the elements of the best practices. And we want people to know when AI is going to be used to evaluate them, an employee, in a particular way. At a particular moment in time, there might be one, two states who actually have a requirement that that employees be told or candidates be told about a particular use of AI on their application. But when you focus on the best practices and you focus on the underpinnings of why that's important, you get the benefit of, I guess, for lack of a better word, measuring twice and cutting once, right? So you're building the product. You're building those features, that transparency, to meet what's coming in terms of transparency for all people, even though maybe currently there is only a few jurisdictions where that would actually be required.
There's a lot of hope across the board, especially with individuals that are so focused on making sure that we get this right. We hear a lot of questions from individuals and employers and policymakers about what AI could mean for the future. What makes you both hopeful about this transformational time? And I would have to say an exciting time at that. As you said, you have one of the best jobs in probably out there today. Amy, if I can ask you first, please share with us some thoughts around this transformational time.
As somebody who has been immersed in what the future could look like for so long, it's so interesting to be really in the future. And AI and the tools that we are seeing this year, last year, is giving people more opportunities at lower cost and with fewer barriers to access so much potential that they really could never have gotten to.
Elena, what makes you hopeful about all this transformational time?
I'm going to answer the question in two ways, because I think there's so much hope about the fact that we're having these really thoughtful conversations. And we're collaborating, you know, leaders across the industry collaborating to have these thoughtful conversations now because we know they matter. So I think just in that, I think I'm very hopeful about the future of it. In terms of generative AI and AI and what it can do with our everyday work and how it can improve everyday work processes, I'm just hopeful because it's a tool. It's an amazing tool. But I still view it as a tool, and what I think it's a tool for is really going to be unlocking that human potential, unlocking human creativity.
I certainly hope it's going to be game-changing, and I think it obviously will be. And for somebody in the HCM industry, as a practitioner, as an HR person myself, I am very excited to see what continues to come. So not only this conversation, but many others. Such an important conversation that no doubt we will only continue to evolve. Elena, Amy, thank you both so much for sharing your insights. For more information, please visit fpf.org. Thank you for joining us.